Truck drivers on cease work demanding adequate security on National Highway 37, Imphal-Zirebam Road. Manipuri diaspora in Myanmar eagerly wait for the day when they can travel without any restriction to India. Imphal Literature Festival kicks off at Lamyanba Sanglen. Delegates from Myanmar, Bangladesh, Tripura and Assam are participating in the three-day event. And Anova Imagi Mangal Khabam and Seren Sporting Union Singjamay booked their berths in pre-quarters of the 59cc meet. Hello and welcome to Impact News. You are watching Primetime News. I am Tensubham Ranita with the top stories and latest news at this hour. Truck drivers plying along Imphal-Zirebam Road have ceased work from today in protest against the lack of security measures along the stretch of the National Highway 37. They are demanding appropriate security measures on the road. Speaking at a press meet held at All Manipur Road Transport Drivers and Motor Workers Union office at Hotel Yaisena, General Secretary of the Union, Maimom Anil Maitei said some unidentified miscreants torched a truck bearing registration number MN03T0196 at Lengangpokpi on December 3 around 6:30 p.m. The truck was carrying cement. He also said the government should take responsibility of the incident and demanded compensation for the loss. He also demanded action against the police personnel concerned. Maimom Anil said there have been cases of extortion of money and mobile phones from truck drivers along the highway in the last 2 or 3 months.
Akoina Manipur ki home ju pubireba deputy CM da akoina masigi security gari chaliba gari singjiga driver handyman me amma chali siga piriba Manipur government ki security siga sanadre maduna akoi security masing hengat piu haibi se akoina haijadre lakpani adu masing asi bodu Manipur government na tadran lakpani aduna lambi sidang asi thoiba crime mam se aduna maruina akoi ki security arrangement je chapchana pidragadi akoi pidri phawba driver singna akoi lambi sida akoi ngasi degi national highway 37 sida Drivers in the starting pyre, Ambu Pyroy, and the Gai Lamisida, Ambu Chatanaba, driving in a fit up lower.
Meanwhile, Manipur Truck Owners Welfare Association President Hijam Ranjit also expressed his support for truck drivers. He said there have been two cases of looting at Nungkau. He said there is a disproportion between the number of trucks and the security provided and appealed to provide highway protection force along the national highway.
Highway protection force ma to to ba lambi sing si da loina lai gra bani simbol la ka no si da force ma thambi yu ai da na khoina demand tong da sei ka age ma mang di lai adu nga si bhaw ba thaw ma na pang thuk pi de ma du su athu ba matam da highway protection force si yam na athu ma matam da ai di nga sai gi akhan na na bata le na ma dum hang do ga akhan na na dum tau ba ya ba po ni ko scot sa le che dum adu na dum ngak che ba dum ya aduna adugi thabak tumasu manipur government da pangthuk piu haijaningi raibi ne na lowri ba starting pai da bi khongjang chi sapsana ekhoi gari chata bi khongjang hida dum ekhoi cooperation pi ba haina khoi dum lem na le
More than 400 trucks are stranded at Hengbung in Senapati district due to economic blockade in Southern Hills area on Imphal-Dimapur National Highway. Kuki Ingpi Southern Hills, KSO Southern Hills, KWU Southern Hills and several local civil society organizations have called for an indefinite economic blockade in the area from last midnight in protest against non-repair of the road. All the stranded trucks are now at Hengbung taxation checkpost. All goods vehicles are not allowed to pass the road. With a change in government in Myanmar, Manipuri diaspora eagerly waiting for the day when Manipuri Burmese can travel without any restriction to India. Speaking at the felicitation organized by Kelao Patriots in Wanghai Ningthempu Krimapal, Manipuri diaspora Kakching Tabam Sundar Gopal from Myanmar appreciated the Manipur government and various organizations for their warm welcome. He said Manipuri diaspora from Myanmar came to Imphal to see the Sangai festival and they got the opportunity to visit various temples in the state, for which they are grateful to the people of Manipur. The Manipuri team from Myanmar also met titular King Laisenba Sanajawa.
Manipur lag bese yam na harau zai kino Manipur mayam sena akoi utaram na yam na phazana welcome to akoi pung na yam na nungai wa mapang zai matam kai dana mayam se ka loina leib se so khoi pumin da akhoi kawwa ngam loida ba ji phiba ma leise india ji look east policy ai ba ma lag ba ga burma ji democratic movement ma lag ba ji matang se lag pa na matam khuding da lag ba se ya ga da bu ji matam ni lag la ne ai na khan jai.
The descendants of the Manipuri people who were captured and taken to Myanmar during the seven-year devastation, Chahitaret Khuntakpa, were felicitated today by Panthau in Wanghai Hijamlairak. The team, led by Kakching Tabam Sundar Gopal, was presented with Manipuri traditional clothes by Panthau.
Quasi Yamna no sign a kind of curva, quasi meet, meet you in a lie, say, quay Uponki of no sign, we say, Nasi Avenue, Mr. Mitaja Lima, come from the equator, but the Yamna sorva, ama, Pangze and a Kanze.
All Manipur United Clubs Organization, AMUKO, felicitated the Manipuris of Myanmar who came to see Manipur Sangai Festival at Youth Hostel, Kumanam Park. 9 out of 31 Maitreys of Myanmar were felicitated at the function and presented with gifts. Members of different civil society organizations of Manipur attended the function. The centre has informed the Supreme Court that the army cannot be held responsible for alleged encounters in Manipur as it was discharging its sovereign function to defend the nation from external aggression. Attorney General Mukul Rohtagi yesterday said Justice Santosh Hegde Committee report on alleged 1,500 extrajudicial killings should be rejected. The committee had found in its report that the encounters were not genuine and the victims did not have any criminal record. Rohtagi told a bench of justices Madan B. Lokur and U.U. Lalit that the army was only discharging its function of defending the country from external aggression, so the force cannot be blamed. He also said the report is already pending secure scrutiny of the government. Justice Hegde Committee was appointed in January 2013 to hold an inquiry into alleged fake encounter killings in Manipur after a PIL was filed by the families of the victims. The election of Manipur University Students Union MUSU has been rescheduled for tomorrow and the polling will be held from 11 a.m. to 2 p.m. The election earlier scheduled for today could not be conducted due to disturbances by the students. Sources said the head of Computer Science Department, Assistant Professor Rajmani, has been reinstated. The student leaders held a meeting with the Vice Chancellor, Professor H.N.K. Sharma, and agreed to hold the election tomorrow. The meeting also agreed to reinstatement of the Assistant Professor Rajmani. It may be recalled that the Vice Chancellor removed the head of Computer Science Department from his post in connection with a student election. The election was rescheduled after there were disturbances following a complaint lodged by a candidate of the Games and Sports Secretary against his opponent that her attendance was low. However, both the candidates are allowed to contest in tomorrow's election. Pre-conference workshop was held today in connection with a two-day 22nd East Zone Pedicone and 19th Mani Pedicone 2015 to be held on December 5 and 6 at City Convention Centre, Palace Compound. The workshop on basic neonatal ventilation held at Mother's Care Children Hospital and Research Centre, Sagolban, Moirang Lairak, was organised by Pediatric Association of Manipur. Senior pediatricians, including Dr. Kanya Mukhopadhyay, Dr. Ravi Shankar K and Dr. Rita Bora delivered lectures on basic neonatal ventilation. Several doctors from RIMS and GenIMS also attended the pre-conference workshop. The two-day conference, to be organized under the aegis of India Academy of Pediatrics, is expected to be attended by senior pediatricians and specialists.
Conference, the pre-conference workshop, koina hojik sikta yamna darkar leiba subject amada koina discuss toraga kan workshop tau se koi chanai adum koi kanaw moina da manipur yewa na de koi se de anga pipa tha su da bangang gum ba de pok da ngai koi de bangang mem siki kya da pent lesson workshop se koi na plan tau se
Handicap Development Foundation Manipur and Handicap People's Front Tamil Nadu District jointly observed the International Day of Persons with Disabilities at a function held yesterday at Tupul Community Hall in Tamil Nadu District. ADC Tamil Nadu member Zeno Kamai, chairman of Longmai, Adai Kamai, advisor and president of HD Foundation, attended observance held on the theme Inclusion Matters, Access and Empowerment for People of All Abilities. Kaikilan Briantak from Kabui Kulin, Tamelong and El Kaiko Saupuna from Mau Karong in Senapati who are participating in the ongoing Winter Disabled Mela for Inclusion Society at Tera Kebol School lamented that till now they have not got any help from the government. Speaking exclusively to Impact News, Kaikilan Briantak said due to an accident in 1996, he became a person with disabilities and till now he did not get any assistance from the government. El Kaiko Saupuna appealed to the government to provide them disability certificate at the earliest. He also appealed to all concerned to organize Mela for the disabled in the near future too.
Ai gumna soinai ba disabled khoi khunne so khoi area da so yamna lai adu bu moi di certificate pai da ba mayam oibini na kai su kana ba government de gi mateng amata su phangma leite health center da oriso awareness gumasi lobby ra ga mayam gi this certificate si phangkhan biu adu ga government gi mateng haji kasi da oriso kana ba du phangkhan biu
akhoi gumba mi mana draba disabled khoi se government na oriso ngo khoi na oriso Nishimpira ga akuibo akuibumba bise mi mamanda putopio aina hainingi aduga government dashu akuibo akuibumba bise noin mateng kaya gumba piridik nungai gini nakale.
One day advocacy workshop on child protection for the functionaries of SSA, NHRM, ICDS and ICPS was organized by Social Welfare Department at Hotel Classic. Director of Social Welfare and State Commission for Persons with Disabilities, L. Nabakishore Singh, Chairperson of Manipur State Commission for Protection of Child Rights, S. Sharad Kumar Sharma, staff of the Social Welfare Department, took part in the workshop. Several experts spoke on the problems facing the children and the urgent need to resolve them. Deputy Director of Social Welfare Department, T.S. Joychandra Singh, said the workshop aims at understanding the needs of the children and providing them.
Angang sing se akogi moida sapchaba protection pibirga protection harga akoina lairik tambada sabada laibada hingbada khudimakta oina mokhoibu ngakpi senbina bagi damakta mamuta na khangmina bam sangi lairiba stakeholders sing hadi block level da district level da lairiba ai digi department khuding lairiba field functionaries meam sing sa akoi ngasi punchan minerega mokhoida sapchaba gyanama amadi mokhoida togadoba karino hasi akoi no workshop oina pangthok binerega madu gi khongthang do lokhatna bagi damakta ahan boina ngasi akoi department of social welfare na asing ma kalgi sa akoi workshop ase akoi pangthok sabani
3-day Imphal Literature Festival organized by Sahitya Thopangluk began today at Lamianba Sanglen Palace Compound. The festival aims at promoting and conserving Manipuri culture and literature. Delegates from Myanmar, Bangladesh, Tripura and Assam are participating in the 3-day festival. As part of the festival, Konthaujam Suranjits, Nong Amavdi, Upambi and Chinghai Angom's Pebet Ki Pena were also launched. Both the poets are from Bangladesh. Nong Thambom Kunjamohan Award 2015 was conferred to R.K. Brajendra in recognition of his contribution in the field of translation. The award carries a cash prize of Rs. 10,000, a shawl and a citation. Addressing the gathering, Social Welfare and Cooperation Minister A.K. Mirabai stated that it is the right time for the people to unite for the promotion and conservation of Manipuri culture and literature. She also said the state government will try to extend possible support to the Manipuri people living outside Manipur.
Ado butase namak nasi di ekwai Manipuri sahitya gi pukai ese thannabo banabada tongan tongan ba nasi ekwai Bangladesh da leriba Myanmar da leriba Tripura da leriba amadi Assam da leriba mayam punamak na punsin aduna ekwai gi loan amasung Dari bapak kita ini saya masih ikhui mangan bayar deh. ꯁꯤ ꯄ꯭ꯔꯤꯖꯥꯔꯕ ꯇꯧꯅꯕ ꯑꯃꯗꯤ ꯍꯦꯟꯅ ꯍꯦꯟꯅ ꯃꯄꯥꯡꯒꯜ ꯀꯟꯈꯠꯂꯛꯅꯕ ꯍꯣꯠꯅꯕꯗ ꯍꯦꯟꯅ ꯑꯩꯈꯣꯏꯒꯤ ꯂꯩꯔꯤꯕ ꯄꯨꯀꯩ ꯂꯪꯒꯩ ꯑꯣꯏꯔꯤꯕ ꯑꯩꯈꯣꯏꯒꯤ ꯁꯥꯍꯤꯇ꯭ꯌꯒꯤ ꯄꯨꯀꯩ ꯂꯪꯒꯩ ꯑꯣꯏꯔꯤꯕ ꯃꯌꯥꯝꯁꯤꯡ ꯑꯁꯦ ꯃꯌꯦꯡ ꯇꯥꯍꯟꯕ ꯌꯥꯗꯦ.
A team of students from Manipur left Imphal today to participate in the national level Kala Utsav 2015 to be held from December 8 to 11 in New Delhi. Education Minister Moirang Them Okendro flagged off the 42-member team comprising 36 students and 6 teachers in front of his office at Secretariat North Block. Minister Okendro advised the students to give their best performance to bring laurels for the state and asked the teachers to guide the students. The students were selected from the state level Kala Utsav held at MFDC Auditorium in Palace Compound. The students will perform dance, music, visual arts and theatre at national level Kala Utsav. Students from Senapati district will give performance in music. Students from Bishnupur district will perform in theatre. Students from Imphal East in visual arts and students from Imphal West will perform dance. The Ministry of Human Resource Development is organizing a festival from this year to encourage students in the field of arts and culture. Women in Education 2015 scholarship sponsored by Canadian Teachers Federation was distributed to the winners today. The scholarship was presented to 6 girl students at a function held at Manipur Press Club by All Manipur Elementary School Teachers Association MSTA. MSTA General Secretary C.S. Shanta Kumar said the annual scholarship sponsored by Canadian Teachers Federation aims at encouraging girl students in their studies and helping them in taking a major role in the society.
All Manipur Elementary School Teachers Association na samnajaduna aikoi Canadian Teachers Federation na oja nupi gi macha nupi singna oja gi sinpham da training chalabadi adu da chaliba oja sing adu gi merit amasung ma gi achievement gi matung ina khaina khallaga kumchi jahi gi waina oja nupi gi macha nupi tarukta palising manga manga gi sentang ase ngasi gi chama thorom sig lo na yen tok chabani oja nupi sing bu khare han sangsil lang na ba macha nupi sing su hen encourage ono bu gi sinjalang jabani.
Manipur Muslim Welfare Organization will celebrate 5th Foundation Day on the 7th of this month. The event will be held at Manipur Press Club. The Muslim body in a press release has appealed to civil societies, clubs and organizations not to call for bun or general strike on the day. Representatives of Loi Kakching RO Oil have extended financial assistance to 5 persons who have cleared the preliminary of Civil Service Examination 2015. It began today at Thawal District Council Counting Hall. The program was inaugurated by DC Thawal T. Ranjit. Now news from the world of sports. First, the CC Mid. Anoba Imagi Mangal Khabam and Sudan Sporting Union Singzame have booked their berths in the pre-quarters of the 59th Sir Chorchan Singh KCSI CBE Memorial Football Tournament at Mapal Kangjibung. In the third match of the tournament, Anoba Imagi Mangal Khabam Srisang Pemika Somboshi scored their solitary goal in the 60th minute to defeat Kakching Popular Sporting Club 1-0. In the fourth match of the tournament, Southern Sporting Union Singzame trashed Highway Stars Union Thawal 7-1 to reach the pre-quarters. SSU Singzame's El Gogo Cha scored a hat-trick and 2 goals, while T.S. Roshan and T. Arun netted 1 goal each. N. Raju of Highway Stars Union Thawal scored the lone goal for the losers. North Imphal Sporting Association Thangmaiban and Yaiphalamjing Club Jiribam will lock horns tomorrow. DSA Southern Hills will take on Imphal West District Football Association in the final of the 27 Junior Boys Inter-District Football Tournament. In the second semi-final of the tournament, Imphal West District Football Association humiliated DSA Bishnupur by 9 goals to nil. SH Netraji scored 4 goals, while TH Kishan, A. Suranjoy, K. Johan, N. G. Janis and L. Monish scored 1 goal each. The tournament is organized under All Manipur Football Association at Kumalam Park Artificial Turf Ground. The final match will be held on December 6. Arang will host one of the best football leagues of Northeast on the theme Say No to Bandh. The tournament will kick off tomorrow at TNL Ground, Ukhrul tomorrow at 10 a.m. 16 teams are participating in the tournament. Manipur will take part in the 42nd Junior Boys National Volleyball Championship to be held at Rajendra Stadium, Chhapra in Bihar from December 8 to 13. The team including 12 players, coach Y. Babu Macha and manager K. H. Ram will leave Imphal on the 6th of this month. Before we end, let's take a look at the headlines once again. Truck drivers on cease work demanding adequate security on National Highway 37, Imphal Ziribam Road. Manipuri diaspora in Myanmar eagerly wait for the day when they can travel without any restriction to India. Imphal Literature Festival kicks off at Lamyamba Sanglane. Delegates from Myanmar, Bangladesh, Tripura and Assam are participating in the three-day event. And Anova Imagi Mangal Kavam and Southern Sporting Union Singzamai booked their berths in pre-quarters of 59 CC men.